Hello once again, audience. It's me, Sergio Cimarelli, because I can't show my face right now. So, I have to show my face on my 50th video. So, on my 50th video of my channel, I can show you my face reveal soon. Anyway, so this is me without camera. So I'm going to play this game. I found this on Steam, which is called Mythgard. It's like Hearthstone and Magic Arena, but it looks more like the movies such as Onward and Bright. So this is how I play. So it's like this. There are game modes here. Gauntlet, puzzle, story. Does it have tutorial mode? Yes, I play tutorials. So it's not a story. So I completed the first three chapters of the story. Okay, don't know what to play this game? Okay, let's see how it goes. So this.
Welcome to Mythgard, a tactical CCG set in a world of modern magic, cyberpunk werewolves, and missing gods. This short tutorial goes through the basics of combat. It only lasts 8 turns, so pay attention.
Okay. So this is like Hearthstone. So let me show you.
The first thing I need to do is burn a card. Burning a card gives me 1 mana and 1 gem. Mana and gems refresh every turn. This Magmatar is powerful, but it's expensive. Burn it now.
Okay, to burn a card, you have to drag and drop it below. From your hand,
that you burn, get shuffled back into your deck. There's a good chance that Magmatar will be back. Alright, that Minitar costs 1 mana and 1 red gem. Now, let's create a minion. Most minions are sluggish when they're first created. It should perk up the next turn. End turn.
So, this is like Hearthstone mixed with Pixar's Onward.
Paths are passive abilities that provide a foundation for your deck. You choose your path when building your deck. Because your path just progressed to the spring season, you gained 1 life. Burning cards builds up my resources. After a few turns, I'll be able to play more powerful cards. I should burn this Forlorn Spirit.
Okay, so I'll have to burn this card now.
Alright, now I have 2 mana to use each turn. Powers are active abilities that cost a small amount of mana and can be used once per turn. Your power, Infuse, increases the strength of 1 of your minions. Use your Infuse power on your Minitar now.
So I have powers, huh?
Looks like that Minitar is ready to start fighting. Minions threaten the 3 lanes in front of them.
So I'll have to
use your Minitar to attack 1 of the 3 opposing lanes. Okay, now end your turn.
So this special power has this. This is like activate ability.
Remember that when you burn a card, you get both 1 mana and 1 gem. The color of the gem that you get is determined by the color of the burn ring on the card that you're burning. There are 6 colors in Mythgard, and each corresponds to a different faction. The flexible mana system lets you support 2 or 3 colors easily. Burn your Dora so that you have 3 mana. This will give you your first green gem. Flames are the heart of Mythgard's combat system. When a minion attacks, it must prioritize attacking enemy minions. With a sniffer in the way, your minotaur is blocked from attacking your opponent directly. If you attack now, both the minotaur and the sniffer will die. Not a bad trade. Play your Matryoshka artifact. You have 5 artifact slots. Stacking artifacts occupy the same slot. When you damage a player, you also damage the artifact in their outermost slot. An artifact's durability is shown in the bottom left corner of its card, or at the bottom of its icon. Unlike minions, artifacts can be used the turn they are played. Use your Matryoshka to buff your Minotaur. Attack with your powered up Minotaur. Okay, that Minotaur is doing a lot.
Wow. So, last Wednesday, I installed this game, and it's kind of fun. It's like Magic, and sometimes
it's
also digital train card games. Alright.
Remember that your path is a passive ability that you choose when you build your deck. Because it just progressed to fall, you drew an extra card. Burn the Gemhold Dwarf you just drew, so you have another green gem. Plane enchantments change the board. They often provide benefits to any minion that occupies the enchanted lane, but they can also have other effects. Minions can change lanes, but moving to a new lane uses up their action for that turn. Let's get that Minotaur away from that Valkyrie Tough. Move her onto your red carnival. End turn.
That was intuitive.
You took 3 damage from that attack. Since your Matryoshka has durability, it also took 3 damage. If an artifact runs out of durability, it is destroyed.
Oh. I have to wait for my turn to do it.
Burn the Night Hag for your 3rd green gem. Let's do something about that ensnaring serpent. Play your Sky Ranger.
Approaching target.
Some minions have active abilities. Use 2 green gems to activate the Sky Ranger's ability. Use your Matryoshka to buff your Sky Ranger, then attack the ensnaring serpent. Both will die, but it also clears away from your Minotaur. Now attack the ensnaring serpent. The Minotaur is now powered by your turn and has a clear attack on your opponent. What are you waiting for? Attack!
Alright, it's my chance.
Let's try attacking from multiple parts of the board. Play your Strigoi Pureblood in the far right lane.
May I come in?
Go ahead and end your turn.
Okay. So this is kinda intuitive like that. But I'm going to see.
Fortier!
Avatar is just what we need to win this turn. We can't burn it because you burned it earlier. See the used burn ring and the burnt look of the card? Burn the Forlorn Spirit. First, use Marching Orders to set those blockers up for the Magmatar's powerful Awaken ability.
Right, I have to target the player first.
Awaken abilities happen only once, but they happen immediately when the minion comes into play. Now, play your Magmatar and destroy all three of your opponent's minions.
So, tap.
Flame!
Looks
take
like
you.
We're about to win. Back to destroy pure blood. Finish it by attacking with your Minitar.
Alright. Game over. So this is a really great game. Now I've unlocked two reverse player. Two-player mode. Or rather,
there's a lot to learn in Mythgard. Here are some of the best game modes for you to try next. Story mode. You opted out of the story, and that's your call. But the 15-game story unlocks some great rewards. Puzzles. The first 8 puzzles show you how some important minion abilities work. Gauntlet. A few runs of the PvE draft mode can help you get a feel for the game. But make sure you pick a faction first and get started on unlocking those great faction rewards.
So this is a great game. Like Magic. Anyway, I have to pick a faction. So I have to wait. There are 6 of them. Norden is blue. Aslan is yellow, Avros is red, Dreni is green, Parsa is orange, and Harmony is indigo violet. So I picked this one because I played this one. So that's it, I picked my faction. Well, that's about it. I have to claim my rewards first, and now I see it. Yes! A booster pack! You wanna see a booster pack? You gotta go to your collection. Well, whatever. So, let's see what happens. So, you have to drag this off to the market. Subscribe to this channel, and as always, peace out.